about how Sunday is Valentine's Day, and if you want a surefire way to spice things up in the bedroom, then look no further than our next guest. Here to show you some quick and easy DIY tips to turn your bedroom into a love nest this weekend, we are joined by the living room's interior designer and master builder, Barry Dubois.
I love you.
Start
right back in,
Shalise. Barry, I think I'm going to have to start calling you Boudoir Dubois.
Well, now, go ahead.
I was going to say that a lot of us are just totally clueless when it comes to creating a romantic setting in the bedroom. So where on earth do we start?
Well, many of us start like this, just a white bedspread, white walls, all very bland. Mm. Now, what I'm going to do with the help of the beautiful Crystal from Design Twins is give you a couple of tips how we can bring some romance into the bedroom with textures and colours. It starts with the understory. What looks really bland now, if we fold that back, we've got some gorgeous French linen here. As you know, Angelique, French linen lasts a lifetime. Beautiful contrast with the colours here, but the texture on the skin there is beautiful. We can couple that together now with some layers. Oh. Start with some pillows. It's already making a transformation. Again, as I said, it's about texture. Different textures on the pillow, as well as different colours, really starting to bring some interest into the bedroom now, and you can see this has only taken seconds so far. This is important. The bedroom is a place that many of us leave to last to decorate, but it's the place where you really want to express your personality. Some of us do that with the bed head, but others aren't lucky enough to have that. Now, whether it's padded or it's leather, or if you like a bit of wood in the bedroom, the bed head is where to do it. Pardon? If you haven't got the, if you don't have the bed head, you need to create a focal point, and that can be done with art. Now, some of us like the French classics, as you know, watercolours, but the client for this project is a discerning character, and it's important to him, and I won't say who it is just yet, but it's important to him to express his personality, to say in this piece of art exactly who he is. So when you enter the doorway into this room, you know what this room's all about, and I think no more needs to be said. Thank you, Crystal. Enters this room, you're going to be drawn to that. Yep. You know what is happening in this bedroom now.
Yep.
Joe?
I tell you what, Baz, I don't know much about art, but I know what I like.
Joe's given me a brief, and what he has said is he wants to bring out his inner beast. And from an earlier waxing, I've been able to create a beautiful throw for the end of the bed. And again, this is about contrast and colour. Gorgeous.
I like that.
Just from the back only.
Now, I must admit, when I saw that picture, I wanted to throw, so, yeah.
Now, I want to say, like a cold shower in the honeymoon suite, the way to kill mood in a bedroom is lighting. Now, Jess, you'll be interested in this. I've got something in the bedside table here that is really going to spice up the bedroom. Wow.
That's not very mechanism, interesting.
It's not what I expected.
This is, it does get interesting. This little mechanism here, once hung on the side of the light there, what I get to do is bring in some interesting lighting off the shelf from Bunnings. You can just wrap that around and hang that. Already, it's getting stylish. But this isn't about the light as such. This is more about the shadows that it casts. You can see that. Just some movement in the bedroom. It's like the twinkle of the moonlight on the doona. This is starting to spell romance, no doubt about it. Okay, couple more things. When all else fails, obviously, you've got to have scented candles.
Yes.
You've got to have flowers.
Yep.
And of course,
beautiful.
Just flood the area with petals. Beautiful. And as my Spanish mate says, if all else fails, bang on a Spanish accent and get yourself some breakfast in bed.
Right.
And Joe, if you're not having any luck at this stage, give the game away.
And it's going to be a huge night tonight, on the living room tonight with a big makeover, right?
I've got a fantastic makeover night, a young couple looking to spice up their bedroom. They've had some twists and turns in their life, but we really do something magical there. Miguel, as usual, cooking for love and teaches a young man how to entice his woman with food. Jamie Jury's joining the show, and he's going to show us how to make interesting stuff with flowers. And Ben Stiller has been interviewed by Amanda Keller, and that is a Zoolander moment.
Big Bois, thank you very much indeed. The series Return of the Living Room is tonight at 7:30 right here on 10. Thank you very much.